Hi students, I am glad to meet you through this media after a long gap. Hope that you are very eager to learn 12th standard portion. Let's begin botany session. Let's start from a very simple topic, reproduction in plants. Reproduction in plants. This topic is very familiar to you because you may learn from your very lower classes. Define reproduction. Reproduction is one of the essential process of living organisms on the earth. So it's one of the vital process by which the organisms are existing on the earth. When it is existing, it shows number of changes through variation. So this process leads to evolution also. Basically, the process of reproduction is categorized under two main headings. They are asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Broadly, the process of reproduction is classified under two categories: asexual method of reproduction and sexual method of reproduction. So let's see one by one. In 11th standard, you learned this topic, asexual method of reproduction, in unit 1. Also, you learned that it is one of the attribute of living organisms. The process of reproduction is the attribute of reproduction. That is one of the feature of this living plants. This asexual method of reproduction seen or observed in lower forms of organisms. What's the difference among these two? Asexual method of reproduction perpetuate the young species without the involvement of gametes, but sexual method of reproduction, there is an involvement of male gamete and the female gamete. So this method, fusion of male and female gametes and forms zygote. But asexual method of reproduction, there is no involvement of gametes. So all the young species, all the species which is developed, or the individuals developed under asexual reproduction, is morphologically and genetically identical. So they are known as clones. Let's see what are the organisms which shows different types of asexual reproduction in lower forms. There are number of methods under asexual reproduction. For example, conidia formation. Formation of conidia in fungus. Example, Penicillium notatum. Conidia formation. Another method is fragmentation. Fragmentation, binary fission, budding, gemma formation. So these are, and also there is a method, regeneration. Conidia, formation of conidia observed in Penicillium. In Penicillium, there is a conidia formation. See here, this is the conidia 4. From here, the conidia is developed. Formation of conidia. So this conidia From this conidia, the young plant, young species is developed. So this is one of the fungal species. This developed conidia. Fragmentation. Fragmentation. There is an alga called Spirogyra. Spirogyra is a filamentous alga. So this filamentous alga, accidentally, when it is detached or when the plant is fragmented, fragment is the simple bit of thallus. The plant body of algae is thallus. When it is detached from the parental one, the simple bit or fragment has the ability to develop into the entire organism. Then binary fission. Binary fission observed in bacteria. A single cell which has the ability to divide. So this divides into new species. So two different species are formed. Then budding in yeast. Yeast and Hydra, budding is the method of asexual reproduction. So buds are developed. This bud detached from the parental one and it develops to the new plant body or new species. Then gemma. Gemma is observed in Marchantia. Marchantia is one of the bryophytes. You know, there are different lower forms of organisms, alga, fungus and this bryophytes. So this bryophyte Marchantia, which also shows the thallus plant body, in this thallus there is a formation of gemma. So this gemma, when it is detached from the parental one, it has the ability to develop into an entire species. Then regeneration. Regeneration observed in Planarium. Here the plant body, when it is detached, when it is cut into different pieces, the head part or the tail part, which is cut into several pieces, each piece has the ability to develop into the new organism. So these all methods are asexual method of reproduction. The young ones formed by this method is morphologically and genetically identical. So they are called as clones. These all methods observed in lower forms of organisms. You know what are lower forms? Fungi, bacteria, this planaria, this bryophytes, these algae or lower forms of organisms. Naturally, higher forms of organism which show sexual method of reproduction, but certain higher plants which shows asexual method of reproduction. In plants, asexual method of reproduction is called as vegetative method of reproduction. Vegetative method of reproduction. In vegetative method of reproduction, again it's classified into two categories. They are natural method and artificial method. There are different types: natural method of reproduction, artificial method of reproduction. So in this method, vegetative buds are developed. Vegetative buds or adventitious buds are developed naturally or artificial method. There are classified into two different types: conventional method and modern method. Natural method, there are some adventitious buds or vegetative buds developed from the plant parts. You know, there are several plant parts. They are common plant parts are root, stem and the leaf. There are some buds arises and these buds are developing into a young plant. That is natural method of reproduction. For example, root, moria. Moria commonly we can say as curry leaf. So in this plant, the root From the root, there is a bud develop. So growing bud. So this bud develops in the root, and there this root is able to develop into the new species when it is detached from the parental plant. Likewise, in dahlia, there are adventitious buds are developed in the root. So these adventitious buds develop into the entire organism. Then stem. From third chapter of 11th class, you learned there are different morphology of plants. In morphologically, the stem part, there are number of modifications. You learned several modifications: subaerial modification, aerial modification, and underground modification. So this stem part, there are two different types of modification: underground modification and subaerial modification. In underground and subaerial modifications, the stem part, they are perpetuate into propagules. Certain parts of this are underground. For example, this underground modification, they are used as a storage organs. For example, in this underground modification, there are rhizome, comb, bulb, as well as tuber. So these all modifications observed in the stem, underground stem. So these all are storage organs, as well as they are perpetuate as a propagule. They germinate, they are able to develop into a new organism. So rhizome, common example is ginger. The botanical name of ginger is Zingiber officinale. In this, there are some buds develops. Look at this. This is called rhizome, the modification. This is the stem modification. Actual part is stem, but this is the modified stem. This why we can say this as a stem, because this part, it is covered by scale leaves. Leaves are present, the nodes as well as the internodes are present here, and there are adventitious buds developed. From this adventitious buds, the new plant arises from this. When it is detached from the parental plant, that this new plant which able to develop into the entire organism. So this is example of rhizome. In banana also we can see this underground stem modification, rhizome. So this rhizome develop into the new species. Likewise, comb, there is an example, colocasia. So comb also able to develop into a new species. Bulb, example Allium sepa. So bulb, this is example for bulb, Allium sepa. The small one, we can say this Allium sepa, onion. So this onion, here there are number of scale leaves. These are the scale leaves, and this is the stem or reduced stem, and these are the adventitious roots. So here this part, here there is a axillary bud. These buds are able to develop into the entire organism. So this is bulb, underground stem modification. Another example, tuber. Tuber example, Solanum tuberosum. Solanum tuberosum. So potato, commonly we can say this as potato. Here there are some eye spots are seen. So this eye spots, which is able to develop into the new species. When you allow it to grow from this region, this is the eye spot, the depressions are called as eye spot. From here it able to develop the buds. From here it develops into the new species. When it is detached from the parental one, it develops into the individual species. So these all examples are underground stem modification. In the same way, there are subaerial modifications. The stem, subaerial stem modification, they are classified into runner, sucker, offset and so on. The runner, if you look at the plant, here there is the root system which is below the soil. So here is the root system. One of the example of runner is centella. So this is the normal plant. Here there is a slender branch arises from this, and here they are able to develop into the roots. From this roots there are some new plant develops. So this is runner. Runner is the slender prostrate branch which creeps on the ground, and when it is creeping the ground, when it is touched to the soil, it develops the root. From the root the new plant is arises. This offset is similar to the runner, but offset is observed in aquatic plants. There is an example of aquatic plant is Pistia. In Pistia offset is present. Offset is similar to runner. This type of the runner develops this type of offset. In aquatic plants we can say this as a offset, a branch which develops, and from this branch a new species arises. Then sucker. Sucker example, chrysanthemum. In chrysanthemum there are this same branch is developed. They are called as sucker, but this runner is produced above the soil, but sucker develops below the soil. What's the difference? Here this is the parental plant, here is the root. This branch, long slender branch, develops below the soil and it develops the root, and it is able to grow as a new species when it is detached from the parental one. That is sucker. So runner, sucker and offset are examples of subaerial modification. These all are able to propagate into a new species. So these parts are called as propagules, reproductive propagules. They produce the new species. So root, stem as well as the leaf. Certain plants we may see that the leaf part, one of the example is bryophyllum. In bryophyllum the leaf produces adventitious buds in its margin. Here the adventitious buds are developed. Now this area is called as notch. That means the edges of this, the margin. From this margin this adventitious buds are developed in the leaf. These buds are called as epiphyllous bud. From this epiphyllous bud the entire plant, when it is detached from the parental one, each one has the ability to grow as the entire species. The new species can develop from this epiphyllous buds. One of the example, bryophyllum. Now these all methods are natural method of propagation, vegetative propagation. Then artificial method. In artificial method there are two different types, conventional method and modern method. Conventional method is very common method. We are also following this conventional method of propagation in plants. They are cutting, grafting and layering. Cutting, grafting, layer. So cutting, the plant parts are cut into pieces, either the root or stem or leaf is cut into pieces. We are practicing in rose plant. The cut end of the stem, when it is planted in the soil, it can develop into the entire organism, entire species. So cutting, grafting. There are certain plants are grafted. The grafting, there are two different species are needed. The plant which is attached to the plant part which is attached to the ground is called as stalk. Stalk. And another plant part which is going to graft from here is called as scion. So in grafting, two different plant species are going to graft, join together and allow it to grow into the same species. Two different parts of the plant, two different plants are grafted and allow it to grow as the one species is called grafting. So in this method, grafting, that also one of the conventional method of reproduction. Then layering. Layering also very common method. Layering in jasmine, we used to layer the plant. Layering, there are two different types in layering. Here, mound layering and air layering, two different types. Mound layering and air layering. In mound layering, here, this is the soil, here is the plant. In this, the flexible branch is selected. Near to this soil, the flexible branch of this plant is bent down and it is allowed to develop the root inside the soil. And this develops the root, and it develops when it is develop the root, it is detached from the parental plant and allow it to grow into the new species. This method is called as mound layering. Air layering. In air layering, the nodal region of the branch, this is the plant and here there is a node. In this nodal region, there is a girdle in this part. Girdle encircled the nodal region and this part is covered with polythene cover and keep some moist here, some dust materials or allow it to develop root by applying some hormones and cover it with polythene cover. After few months it develops because it's applying some hormone to develop the root. So here then in this region, nodal region, the roots are developed. After developing this root, this branch is cut from the parental one and it is allowed to grow into the entire species. This method of layering is called as air layer. So these all methods what you learned today is asexual method of reproduction. So today's topic what you learned is asexual method of reproduction. There are several types you have learned. It's not new to you. Already you know it's very clearly you learned in 11th standard. So once again you recall what you learned today. Before the next class you try to learn all these terms. It's easy to you. Thank you.